Today's session will be something boring because it includes lot of methods you have to just keep remember in your mind for reference sake. So it may be some boring lesson is core literature like. So first let me know about shortcuts. How to handle shortcuts. When you go to any these icons, any of these options, you select, you just over the mouse on that, and here a dialog box comes called screen tip, in which maximum of shortcuts you will find, such as I am hovering my mouse on bold and it is showing Control B and that. I move to italic, it is showing Control I for italic. So maximum of them having the shortcut, but those items who don't have shortcuts, we have a key, such as I want to create all borders here, and I want to merge and center. We should know about some shortcuts that how we gonna do all these things. Do you know how to do it?
No, the one creation of shortcuts, no. I just remember some of the shortcuts like Control B and Control I, Control U,
Yes.
Control C,
So
Control H, yeah.
when we press our Alt key, Alt, you just
Yeah.
press it once, Alt,
Yeah.
it shows some keywords here.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
So I am selecting my area and I want to fill with border, all borders. So I press Alt once and the key here, you can see for home, H, for insert it is N, for page layout it is P, and for formulas it is M. Such as all the options have some keywords. When you press this keyword, such as home is showing H, you press H after that. After pressing Alt, you press H. Then more keywords come to you, appears on screen. And now we want to go in borders. So down to the borders, it is showing B. My next keyword is B now. I press B, I enter into border section, and for all borders, it is showing me A. I pressed A, and now the borders has been applied here. Now my shortcut for applying border is Alt H B A. And generally our keyboard typing in most is more faster than our mouse movement. So you will be in super speed while doing that. Now you want to merge and center, and how you will develop your shortcuts, you press Alt, press H, and for merge and center it is M, and merge and center option is C. You press C, it will merge. Now I want to fill color here. Alt H for filling color, H again. For no fill, there is a keyword as N, but there is no keyword. Now, if you want to move in between the colors, you have to use your arrow keys. For such kind of things, you can move your arrow keys. So, if you want to fill colors, Alt HH and move your mouse where you want to fill. Such as this, I have filled green. Now I know to remove this color, I have to press Alt H H N. So there are so many shortcuts you can observe and use it by leaving your mouse for some time. What do? You generally leave your mouse for some time and try doing these kind of things, such as I have to apply the filter. Here is some data and it is name, and I want to apply the filter here. Now what I will do, Alt, it is in our data tab A, and for filter it is T. So Alt AT creates a filter, and again pressing Alt AT, it removes the filter. So by these things you get to know how to use shortcuts.
Alt AT or Alt DFF?
There are four ways for putting your filter. One is Control Shift L. One is Alt H F D. No, no. Alt H S. Yes, it was in old version, and a lot of versions supported. A lot of shortcuts are being obsolete now, but it is yet supporting in this version also. So another shortcut is Alt H S F. Control Shift L, Alt AT, and Alt HSF, and one more thing, Alt DFF. Alt DFF, it is an obsolete shortcut which is yet supported by 2007, but after some time it will be removed in that. Okay, so we must know the new shortcuts of that. What generally happens, we learn shortcuts while we are learning computers in beginning, and after that we don't update our shortcuts. So it's high time to update the shortcuts again, to be updated with the things of Excel or any kind of things. Suppose if you are using Windows 7, you know where is the option for Show Desktop in Windows 7?
Yeah, the bottom right somewhere we have this option. Yeah.
Where?
In my case, okay, come down, further down.
I give you the mouse control. Yes, do it now.
This one.
Yes, correct. So you know this, it is better. But many of the people don't know where it is. So there are lot of more shortcuts in our Windows 7 also. So first let us discuss the shortcuts of Excel, then we will move on to our Windows shortcuts. I just open this Excel again. Yes. So we have known that how to use this ribbon and tab items through shortcut. Now let us use our dialog boxes. We put Control 1 for format cell. For formatting cell we use this dialog box. For navigating dialog box we have different shortcuts, such as for tab navigation in dialog boxes we press Control and why keep pressing the control, we press once tab. I press tab once while pressing the control key and again pressing tab, I move forward in tabs. But if I want to reverse navigation in that, I will press control and shift and then I will press tab. It will come reverse. Now I come to alignment tab and now I have to do this wrap text. You see, there is a small underline in every character, in every option. Such as in wrap text, you will find this underline down to W, and you will find this underline in shrink to fit on K. So for accessing these items, you need to press Alt key, and while pressing the Alt key, you have to press that W. Or if you want to do merge cell, you have to press, while pressing the Alt key, you have to press M. So it will be activated with pressing the Alt key. And you find this green area, that means it is activated on your Enter button. If you press Enter, it will apply all the options. But if you want to escape from that, you need to press Escape. So it is all about dialog navigation. Now you come to know that how to use your tabs, ribbon options, and your controlling your dialog box. Such as if you go to print preview, what is the shortcut for that? Alt F W, Alt F W V. There is a shortcut, and now we do usual do page setup in that. We have shortcut for page setup. Either you can press Alt with S, or you can press Alt P S T. There is also tab navigation rule apply here. Control tab for moving forward, and while pressing Alt you can do landscape, and then press F for fit to one, and press Enter for OK, escape for escaping that window. So now when you are doing all these things, you will be so fast with doing your shortcuts. Suppose I am going to print preview, and I have set all the things, and I escape, I set my page view case, and I have done that, and I shift to normal view. Now I want to create a format. I am applying borders here and putting some colors here instantly. So it somewhere makes you more efficient in using Excel. So you have to search every option. What you do with your mouse, you do with your shortcuts. And how do you come to know more shortcuts, such as we, for inserting new sheet, we use Shift F11. For inserting new sheet, and for deleting that we press Alt E L. For moving that I will use Alt E M to a new sheet. Alt T I will press for new book, and create copy I will see, press Alt C, and for enter it will create new sheet. It is just like using shortcuts very efficiently. So you have to practice a lot on that. And if you want to know more shortcuts, that how to use, how to know more shortcuts, then press F1 from your keyboard and go to show me offline help. There is a help contents over there in search items. There is two types of help contents. One is online and one is offline. So you will find this shortcuts in your offline mode also. Means you don't need to have an internet for you know these shortcuts. You just type keyboard shortcuts here, and there is Excel shortcut and function keys. And in that section you will find each and every shortcut which is being used by Excel. You'll find lot of things in that. You just spend some time for practicing these shortcuts so that you can be more efficient about using these shortcuts. There are a lot of shortcuts or tab navigation or how to use our arrow keys and a lot of signs, control shortcuts, shift tab, control tab, control shift tab, what it usually do. And the next thing after shortcut, you must not about, basically it is the first thing we need to know, limits and specification of Excel specification and limits. What is that actually? It is all about Excel. You have to take a reference for that, because while using VBA you must know that what is the limitation of Excel, because in Excel you will be, by manual use you will be limited using that, because you come down to last row and you got to know that it is about 1 million. And when you are using VBA, then you have to keep in mind that there is this much of rows here and this much of columns here. So for creating reference in mind, you must know about this. For using VBA efficiently, you have to know that what are the limitation of Excel, such as maximum how many sheets can be available in Excel, and what can be the maximum width of your column, what can be maximum height of a row, and such as lot of facts are there, maximum drop down lists 10,000, and there are lot of facts there. For date calculation, earliest date we can calculate it is 1st January 1900, and the latest date we can use, that is 31st December 9999. So there are some limitations, value fields, 256 value fields only a pivot table can have. So this is the reference point for you, that it is available here. You just have to keep in mind that if the limitation of Excel is available in your F1 key in your Excel help. So if you want to take reference in future, you can have this reference, because it is always in Excel. After limits and specification, and after knowing shortcuts, let us know about customization of Excel. why we do the customization, because some of the times there are a lot of settings, or they are in Excel, it sometimes disturbs automatically or disturbed by a macro, so it creates some problem. Unknowingly, sometimes we just reinstall our software by these small problems. So where it is available, it is in your Office button, and go to Excel options. All the Excel customization options are available here, such as in popular tab you will find show mini toolbar on selection. What is this mini toolbar? When you type a text and select that, there is a toolbar appears. It is called mini toolbar. If it is not appearing, you go to Excel option, and this option might be unchecked. That is the reason for not appearing that mini toolbar. Such as what, sir?
It will reduce our performance of the Excel sheet if you are activating this option.
No, not much like that, because we are using 2007. It is now an older version. Now we have 2013, and we have upgraded our RAM so much. It is greater than 1 GB, so it will not affect. It will not so much affect there. So whether it is activated or not activated, it not creates up. What impacts on Excel, I will tell you in our safe option for speed. So we are discussing about this enable live preview. If the option is not checked, what will happen? You are just selected the thing, you are just applying the for any formatting. Here you can see I have not selected yet any option, but it is keep changing here. This is called live preview. The preview will be live on your screen before a proper selection. So it is called a live preview. If it is not coming, it may be that this option is unchecked. And show developers in the developer tab in the ribbon. Here you can see for VBA we use this developer tab. By default it is not appearing in any Excel. But you want to activate this tab, and you have to go on Excel options, and from here you can check that and okay that. You will find that a developer toolbar is now added in your ribbon. Okay, now you can choose your favorite color scheme for Excel, such as I am using silver color. Most of us we using blue, but by default it is blue. It is like that. And one more color scheme is available in 2007. It is black. It looks like black. So whatever we want, we can choose. Now we were knowing shortcuts by screen tip. So there are three screen tip style in our Excel options. First is show features description is screen tip. By default it is selected, but if you don't want to show your features description in screen tip, you can just choose that don't show feature description in screen tip, and don't show screen tip. If by mistake it is selected, then it will not show you any screen tip while hovering the mouse. So while you are practicing these things, you have to keep in mind that these options should not be disturbed. You check each and every option by one time, so that it could not be affected. And now it is showing here. Now you see, I am typing one name here and I am dragging. There are a lot of names appearing here.
Can we use dragging the keyboard itself, not to mouse?
I'm not typing every time. I'm just putting one name and just dragging that.
Yeah, understood. But instead of using mouse, can you able to do it to keyboard? Dragging.
The dragging we can do with keyboard. There is an option, fill. It is all about dragging. Okay, so I will let you know about it in my other sessions. First, we know what we are discussing, that these options actually. I have typed a city, and again I am dragging that. There are a lot of cities. I'm typing a product name here. I'm just dragging that. The product names is also available there. So all the list I have included, which I use frequently, where I can add that, such as I have created some other list, such as choose something stationary, such as pencil, rubber, sharpener, fluid, and blade, and pen, so now I want to add these values in my custom list. So where it is, you go to Excel option, in Tabular itself you will find edit custom list. You just go into that. We sometimes use Sunday, Monday, and we drag that. It always comes to January, February, and there are some names such as Sandeep, AGM, Rice Sugar. There I have put some product, and if I want to add such list, I just have to select that, and import that, and press this add button and OK. And here I will press OK. Now if I type any of the word from the list, I just drag that, all the list will be available here. So it is done through custom list. Now what major problem is, through my popular tab, I can choose my default font, which will be always available in my Excel. What is it? I have chosen Arial and font 11 by default. In normal view I am opening. I can open my Excel sheet as normal view, page break view, or page layout view. And I can decide how many sheets should be in my Excel workbook. I choose 5 and OK. When I press Ctrl N for new, it will show me 5 sheet, the default font, and the default font size. So these options I can customize to get ease of my work. Now let's move on to formulas. In formulas, we put some formulas like that, 10 and 20, a simple formula by adding these two values. Now you can see I am changing the value and it is instantly showing me the result. Sometimes it happens the calculation goes selected manual, the selected manual. Then what happens? You change your data, but the value will not be changed here. What you need to do in that, you go to formula tab, you have to press either F9 for calculation, or you can select automatic calculation from here. The options which are available in Excel customization in formula tab, it is also available in our formula tab here, calculation option, automatic accept data table, or manual. You can choose automatic. So by choosing automatic, when you change the value, it will show instantly, it will show the result. Now let's see another option. There is R1C1 reference style. What is that? It is, you can see here, there is ABCD for column and 1, 2, 3, 4 for rows. So your first column will be called as column, this first cell will be called A1, and you can see there is in column C, the fourth row is selected, it will have the address like C4. But if you have selected this R1C1 reference style, it will convert your ABCD columns into 1, 2, 3, 4, and the reference style will also be changed here. It is like RC-2 plus RC-1. How it is working, just you please press equal to, and basically it is the pointer of your values. You just drag the values. I am creating plus here and I am creating minus here. Creating plus here and it's creating minus here. So this is the reference style the R1C1 works. If you move in right side of columns, it will show you, it will plus in columns, and if you move in rows, it will plus in rows, down move, you know, such as if you press equal to here, if you move to the right, it will increase the column. It is showing RC1. If you move next to the column, it will show RC2, means column 2, column 3, column 4. If you move down, that means you are increasing your rows, and if you are moving upward, it means you are decreasing your rows, such as you are decreasing your columns. So this is called the R1C1 reference style. And the same column will be said R0 and column 0, means the current position. So this is the reference style will be followed by you in VBA. So we use these things for our VBA, this movement actually. You don't have to convert this in R1C1 reference style, but we work like that with the RVBA. Now you have formula autocomplete. You type a formula, and when you pressing tab, it just completing. I am type DL. One second. typing VL, and when you press
no, you get the formula, then tab, then enter.
Yes, actually your my mouse, you are moving your mouse and my mouse is moving here, so that
was not moving. Okay.
Yes, so that was the problem actually. Yeah,
okay.
No problem. Now it will not move. I'll type VL and press tab for completing the formula, that is called formula autocomplete. Okay, so if it is not doing by your pressing tab, that it means this option may be unchecked. Apart from that, we have some error checking rules. What are the, if we use some check numbers, we enter here some check number with zero, we have to put as a text. So it shows a green error here, means you click on that, you will find the error says the number is stored as text, is saying because the default formation is like numbers and we have stored, we are using the check number as text, so it shows that it may be an error that you are storing numbers as text. So it gives us option for convert to number. If we convert, the zero will be removed. So if you don't want this error, or if you want to change the color of this error, you can choose from here the color for this error. And if you don't want the background error checking, you can just uncheck this one. And there are some set of rules for occurring the error. You can select from here. Now let's move to our proofing tab. Sometimes what happens, we want to we are numbering something and we have typed A, we have typed B here, but when we type C here, it converts in copyright sign. The error occurs with R also, it converts in registered sign. So what is that actually? You just go to in our proofing tab in autocorrect option. In autocorrect option, what we find that there is a description over here. If I type C within brackets, then it will be replaced with this keyword, with this character. So it is there. And if I don't want to use this option, then you have to uncheck this option, replace text as you type. Uncheck that, and now you can use the things as you want. But we can take some benefits from that also. Suppose if you have to type long words more frequently, such as you type MK for, and you can choose Murli Krishna, and you add this description in that, when you type MK, it will be automatically replaced in your full name. You just type MK, press enter, it will be converted. So you can use a lot of big words in a shortcut for maximizing your efficiency. Now let's move to another option. I have typed two words here. Two wrong words actually. But when I press F7, it is for a spell check. It shows me this option. I ignore it or replace it. But it is not showing option for these capital words. Sometimes it is a problem. You want that ignore, the uppercase letter should not be ignored. Then you have to uncheck this option, ignore words in uppercase. So it will not ignore your uppercase words. Now you press F7. Then it will do spell check in your uppercase letter also. Okay. Now let's move to our save option. In save option, you can choose your default formats here. The Excel format we generally use that Excel 97 and 2003 format. When the Excel 2007 had launched, then there are a lot of problems with compatibility with previous version. Then we got to know that if we save our workbook in 97-2003 format, it will properly run in our old version. So it was a problem, such as I am using this macro enable workbook. That means when I am doing VBA coding, and if I save in normal Excel format, the all VBA code will be lost while saving. So I have to keep in mind that when every time I am saving the workbook, I must save this with this Excel macro enabled workbook. For the default format, I can set here and save auto recover information. If your file got stopped accidentally, so this your file will be recovered through this auto recover, which is taking recovery in every 10 minutes. So if this option is not checked, then it will not create your recovery file. The auto recover file location you can choose, or it is by default available in this location. You can choose your default location also here, such as I am pressing save as option, F12 key for save as. So it is by default showing desktop and Excel macro enable workbook. So for making these options default, you need to choose these options and these location in your save section. Now suppose if you have opened a very large file, and if your auto recovery is on, it every time saves in 10 minutes. Means in every 10 minutes it will hang your system if you are using a such large file. So there is an exception. You can choose your open workbook and disable auto recover temporarily for those workbook. So it your system will not hang while opening large files. Now let's move to advanced tab. By default, when you press enter, your cursor moves down. You can choose the direction of your cursor through this advanced tab. After pressing enter, move selection, the direction you can choose from here, but generally it is not needed. sometimes when you type a word, the decimal points added automatically. That means your this option may be active. So it will, if you type 1024, it will show as 10.24. So if this error occurs, you can check that point. And sometimes what happens, your dragging partner, your this black dog is sometime hide from this place. It shows like temporary this. We do not find any point to drag our values. We can't drag that. So it is done by this option. If this option is unchecked, then your drag button will not show here. Now it is coming. So these are small things which affects Excel more. By knowing these things, we can use our Excel better and we can tackle almost every errors of Excel. So if you want to change your grid line color, you can change your grid line color. You can set as red or whatever you want. Or grid line color you can change. In many applications you have seen this, how to change your grid line color. So there are a lot of things using that. In customization, you can maintain your quick access toolbar, such as most of the time I'm using paste as values. So I have chosen paste as values in my popular commands, where it is in my quick access toolbar. There, if I copy this and I have to paste a special, I just click on that. This is also a power use of your mouse. So some shortcuts you can you can contain here. From these you can choose. From in every tab you want to go in home tab. In almost every option is available here. Paste values, I have just selected that and added here. Now let's move to add-ins. What are the add-ins? Actually, we create sometimes code, so we choose it, we let it on through our add-ins, such as you choose this add-ins and manage Excel add-ins. You will find there are some keywords like append words, G word. These are the codes I have done in VBA and how it is work. So append work is a file that is consisting of a formula that converts number to word. So the function is nt word and I select this one and it converts into number, number to word. So these function is available in that add-in. So we add some special functions, some user defined functions from add-in. We just go to Excel add-in, browse, we can choose the file. It is with your XLA format or XLA, XLAM or XLA. So we just choose that add-in and it will be included in your Excel application. Now let's move to Trust Center. In Trust Center setting, just go to Trust Center setting and you can choose your ActiveX settings for running macro, it is needed that you can disable all controls or enable, and every time it shows you a yellow bar there. If it is selected, it will not show any yellow bar. Macro settings, enable or enabling or disabling, enabling or disabling your add-ins. Macro settings for enabling, disabling macro. You can choose these things. And this is all about Excel customization and shortcuts. So in our next session, we will